Hey, what's going on, everybody? It's your boy X coming at y'all with a brand new video. And as you guys can see, we have four new moments. And I've actually already recorded this video. And it's the second time going around, but I think it's kind of cool. Two new diamonds, a new amethyst, and a pink diamond. I thought we would get a bronze, maybe, you know, a pink diamond that was power forward, small forward, but similar to the glitched one. Doesn't look like that happened. Or maybe Joel, because they missed him last week, but it doesn't look like that's happened. Maybe even a Zion, I thought. But that's what we got. So, you know, it happens. With OG Anunoby, he's a 6'8" power forward, small forward. I don't know why he's not small forward, power forward, but it's okay. Has a 94 mid-range, a 93 three-point shot, a 90 free throw, 90 speed, 86 speed with ball, and a 90 acceleration, 86 ball handle, good playmaking, but for some reason, no passing vision. Don't get that. 70 driving layup, 60 standing dunk, 80 driving dunk, which is really nice. A 61 interior defense, but a 95 perimeter defense. I have hiccups. I don't know what happened, but now I have hiccups. I'm sorry. 97 lateral quickness, a 98 block, a 86 steal, which is amazing. Check out the badges. Has 11 Hoff, catch and shoot, clamps, heart crusher, interceptor, intimidator, off ball pest, pick dodger, pickpocket, pogo stick, tireless defender, and trapper. Has quick draw and range center both. You can see quick draw and downhill also on gold green machine. He's going to be a great card. Really, really good card. Solid 3 and D. Probably one of the better ones that we have in the game, especially budget-wise. So, super excited for that card. Next, we have Seth Curry, shooting guard point guard, who is 6'2". Has a 95 mid-range, 97 three-point shot, and 85 free throw. 89 speed, 1 acceleration, a 90 ball handle, and great playmaking again. Besides passing vision. I don't get it. 81 driving layup. Sadly, and no dunking. But 74 steal, a 85 perimeter defense, and an 88 lateral quickness. You're going to check out the badges here. Has 15 of them Hoff. Acrobat, Pro Touch, Hillary Finisher, Teardropper, Catch and Shoot, Deadeye, Difficult Shots, Flick Release, Green Machine, Ice in Veins, Range Setter, Slippery Off Ball, Tireless Shooter, Volume Shooter, and Quick First Step. Also has a Gold Quick Draw, Bailout, Lob City Passer, Needle Cutter, Clamps, decent badges, definitely not too bad. Doesn't have handles for days, which kind of sucks, but overall, is still looking like a really, really solid card, especially at the PG position. Next, we have Diamond Shake Milton, who I'm actually debating doing a gameplay on. Kind of excited about this card, and I think it'd be fun to use. So if you guys want to see that gameplay, let me know down below. Has a 92 mid-range, 94 three-point shot, 85 free throw, 92 speed, 1 acceleration, and 89 ball handle with great playmaking. A 94 driving layup, a 70 driving dunk. So I would recommend a coach that has a driving dunk boost as well as a shoe. And that should put it up to a 78, I think, because there's a diamond coach that has that, which is pretty comp, especially if you use somebody else that has like Hoff Floor General or whatever, and that moves it up even more. Could be pretty nice. A 85, sorry, perimeter defense, and 92 lateral quickness, no steal, because only a 60, but not too bad, and no rebounding. Has 21 Hall of Fame badges, Acrobat, because this finisher, contact finisher, fancy footwork, giant slayer, slithery finisher, teardropper, catch and shoot, difficult shots, flexible release, green machine, hot start, range starter, slippery off ball, tireless shooter, volume shooter, downhill, floor general, lob city passer, quick first step, and unpluckable. Has gold dimer, handles for days, needle thudder, tight handles, clamps, some good badges over there, as well as quick draw with that Hoff Range Center is going to be beautiful. Again, I'm super excited about this card. Again, let me know if you guys want to see a gameplay, because I'm excited, and we could get a cheeky little triple upload out with these guys. And then last but not least, we have a pink diamond Kristaps Porzingis. I'm going to show you guys and compare his stats. I've already looked at it a little bit, but there are a few differences. So he has, obviously, a 7'3" power forward center, has a 94 mid and 3-point shot, a 95 free throw, 79 speed, 73 speed ball, 79 acceleration, a 95 stamina, 65 ball handle, and decent playmaking, but he's a power forward, so it's fine. A 78 driving layup, 95 standing dunk, 75 driving dunk, a 92 post hook, 94 post fade, 88 offensive rebounding, a 92 defensive, a 97 block, and 88 shot contest, 94 interior defense. The perimeter defense ain't bad, or the lateral quickness, it's not great, but for a 7'3" guy, it really ain't bad, if we're being honest. It really ain't bad. 22 Hall of Fame badges, deep hooks, drops, and pick and roll, and put back boss, catch and shoot, corner splitters, dead eye, deep fades, difficult shots, flexible release, green machine, hot zone hunter, pick and roll, and pump fake, maestro, tireless defender, volume shooter, dream sake, post pick technician, brick wall, heart crusher, intimidator, and rim protector. Has gold quick draw and range extender, and some nice other badges. And I saw some people were complaining that he did not have Hoff range extender, but if I'm being honest, it really is not a huge difference between gold and Hall of Fame. I'm not saying that there isn't a difference. I'm just saying that the difference that there is isn't as big of a deal. He's 7'3" with gold range extender. Every shot that you're really going to be taking is probably within gold range extender, you know, distance, especially off the pick and pop. So I think you're perfectly fine with it and shouldn't worry too much about it. But going to go compare players, like I said, so you guys can see the differences in the Porzingis. The left side will be our 98, and the right side will be the 97, as you guys can see. So Because I've already done this, this 98 is better. Not just because he's one overall better, but he has, as you can see, 4 less gold badges, but 7 more Hall of Fame. So all 4 of those badges turned into Hall of Fame badges, and then he got some more, which is pretty cool. 7 total more Hall of Fame badges in general. Now, he has some slight boosts, draw foul, post hook, a speedball ball boost, a, what is it? Free throw boost right there. You can see a little bit in speed and acceleration, a little bit in hustle and durability, more in his defense, a little bit in rebounding, but it's really not too crucial, if I'm being honest. The boosts really aren't there. It's slightly better defense, slightly better athleticism, and I don't know if that really warrants too much of a boost. Those 7 extra Hall of Fame badges is really what is going to influence my decision on picking up the card. I think that he's worth maybe a good 20 to 30k increase in MT value, but maybe if you already have this one, there's no point in upgrading, for being honest. If you already have this KP, I want to upgrade to this KP, but if you want to, definitely can. Just my tips on what I think you guys should do. Like the video you guys did enjoy, let me know what you guys think of these cards down in the comment section below. Let me know if you guys want me to do that Shake Milton gameplay. I can definitely get that out to you guys. And yeah, subscribe if you guys are new. On that road to 4.5k, thank you guys so much for hitting 4.4. It really means a lot to me. Hope you guys have a great rest of your day, and I will see y'all in the next video. And I got this soul.